traditionally, Indian men would write in pictures parts of battles that they had taken part in, and Red Horse drew 41 pictographic accounts of his participation in the fight at the Little Bighorn, and he participated both in the battle with Reno and in the battle with Custer's troops. Red Horse was a Minicozhi Lakota, and he later settled at what became the Cheyenne River Reservation in South Dakota. He lived for a time on the Standing Rock Reservation. He was a known warrior of his people. He was a head councilman, and his is one of the earliest accounts. It's also one of the most extensive Indian accounts in drawing of that battle. What he concentrates on are the aspects of the battle or the parts of the battle that he actually took part in. Custer split his forces, and Reno was the first contingency or the first set of soldiers in that was sent in. After you see these sets of soldiers moving into the camp, you have depiction of frames of teepees, just whole sets, five pictures of teepees, and there are no people or anything, but what that indicates is that it was a camp, it was a large camp, and there were many women and children and older people, because if the men were by themselves, they would not have camped in teepees, they would just make these brush structures. Confusion of the battle is shown, I think, probably in large part by the horse hooves. Reno's troops were fairly quickly repelled, and they notice then that there are more troops coming. They see Custer coming, and Custer's moving toward the other camps, and they go in to try to defend their women and children, and that's where they encounter Custer, and that whole battle begins. Apparently the battle lasted all of about 45 minutes. All of the accounts will talk about that, the fact that it just, everything happened very quickly. There was a lot of dust. There was tremendous amount of confusion. It was a very hot day, but everything was over very quickly. You get in these drawings this real sense of the tumult and the ferocity of the battle that occurs through these drawings. Very few of the soldiers seem to be defending themselves and so on, and there are accounts of the fact that some of the soldiers just were scattering in many directions. One soldier has his gun pointed up in the air, and it seems to be possibly he's being jerked back or something like that, but just this pointless kind of shooting. The soldiers are depicted in uniform. They're all pretty much stylized in rows, and in sign language, the soldiers were indicated by all in a row. There are very few characteristics that distinguish one from the other. They normally have their uniforms on, and they will have beards, and those were characteristics of non-Indian people. They were normally referred to as hat wearers sometimes, or people with hairy faces. The Indian people, in contrast, the facial features are not very distinguishing, but you'll find that there's a good deal of difference in the clothing that they're wearing, the horses, there's painting on the individuals or on their horses, and all of these are distinguishing characteristics. Some of the warriors that are depicted can actually be, you can actually figure out warrior societies that they belong to by headdresses or by some of the clothing that they're wearing, and then also there are markings on horses. And people that were living, contemporaries of Red Horse, and particularly the warriors, could actually look at this and they would be able to pick out individuals and so on. There are a number of depictions of a warrior with a Strongheart Society headdress, which would be a cap with buffalo horns on it, and then it has a trailing headdress of eagle feathers. And this warrior then is on a variety of horses that are reddish color. I believe that's Red Horse depicting himself taking part in the battle. You have whole pictographic accounts, five drawings devoted just to dead cavalry horses, since the horse was such a primary part of their culture. What the Indian accounts do is give a certain perspective. What they don't do is answer some of the questions that we tend to focus in on, such as who killed Custer, what was the positioning of the troops at certain parts of the battle, and those kinds of things like that. But what you do have is an eyewitness account of the battle from an Indian perspective. More and more historians are looking at the pictographs as possible evidences of history. With archaeological research on the battlefield and so on, the Indian accounts of the battle, which were not considered to be very accurate, are proving to be quite accurate.